Burkhard Heim's mother once asked him, "Son, can you explain your theory in two simple sentences for me?" And Burkhard answered her with just one sentence, which was, "The world has six dimensions." In this video, I am introducing you to Burkhard Heim's view of the world, which has six dimensions, and how you can start to imagine this rather extraordinary perspective. Hello and welcome to Six Dimensions in Color. My name is Hannes Schmidt, and I explain to you Burkhard Heim's world of thought in understandable language and with clear examples. This is the long-awaited English playlist video series about Burkhard Heim. After doing English video, German videos about him for 2 years now on this channel, I'm starting to translate bit by bit all the subjects I've been doing for my German subscribers. I'm going to continue doing German videos, of course, for you, and for my international subscribers and friends. If you are impatient with the publishing of the English videos, all my German videos have, of course, English subtitles. Anyway, I hope this video series brings Burkhard Heim to a wider audience and makes him known across the world. As I said in the beginning, Burkhard Heim assumes that we are living in a world with six dimensions. And now you will ask, how did he come to that, and how do I have to imagine that? Surely this is something only for nerds, or you have to be an Einstein to get a grasp on it. No, I say, because apart from traditional space-time, these two dimensions, these two additional dimensions, are not something that is purely a mathematical trick or something, like in superstring theories. These additional two dimensions are actual real parts of your everyday experience, and they are not esoteric or far-fetched. We are coming to that. Well, first question, why six dimensions? In truth, this was a mathematical deduction at first. Heim found that you could unify the forces of nature in a six-dimensional energy tensor that he figured out in the 1950s. By the way, in the 1960s, the British mathematician and nowadays Nobel Prize winner Roger Penrose also found in his twister theory found a world with six dimensions, but he could not interpret them. But that's something that Heim managed to do. Heim was inspired by the German philosopher Hedwig Conrad Martius. She was a student of Edmund Husserl and the first woman in Germany who earned a doctorate in philosophy. Heim took over many of her ideas and also of her wording. But let's start with our dimensions. Everyone knows dimensions 1, 2, and 3, ordinary space, which has length, width, and height. Space is isotropic, that means you can rotate your three coordinate axes as you like. Space has the same properties in all directions. And if you want to measure it, you have millimeters, centimeters, inches, feet, meters, or light years. Dimension 4 is also well known to everyone. That's time, of course. Einstein said, time is what the clock measures. He didn't know how to define it otherwise. But everyone has a grasp on the concept of duration. And we have seconds, minutes, years, millennia to measure length in the dimension of time. Together with the spatial dimensions, time forms four-dimensional space-time or Minkowski space, which was then by Einstein developed further into Riemann space in the general theory of relativity. And Einstein also said, I stood on the shoulders of giants, meaning by if the pioneers before him had not developed the ideas he could build on, he would never have gotten anywhere. And now we will stand with Heim together on Einstein's shoulders and see where we go from there. First, about the naming of our two additional dimensions. Heim had, as I said, he took many terms of Konrad Martius, but in general he had a soft spot for ancient languages, ancient Greek mainly, and so he called the fifth dimension entelechy, which means having a goal in itself or a meaning, a term that was used by Aristotle already, so it's been in philosophy for way over 2,000 years. And the sixth dimension, he called the aeon, which means the age of the world. So how do we interpret these two additional dimensions? If 1, 2, and 3 are length, and 4 is duration, then what kind of scale or concept are 5 and 6? Dimension 5, Heim interprets as a structural coordinate. That means the higher organized a system is, the higher its coordinate in the terms of x5. You can also call organization an inverse to entropy. And it's also, you can also imagine it as probability. The more organized a system is, the less likely it is to occur statistically. To be sure, the entropy consideration is only valid if you're sticking to dead matter. But we are going to stick to dead matter in this video. I'm not taking a piece of dead matter. Blank sheet of paper. You can say this sheet of paper has a certain structural coordinate. And now I have decreased its structural coordinate. I've made it messy, so I've increased its entropy. And now I have increased its entropy and decreased its structure even further. And now I could go and burn the shreds in my oven, and then I would have it nice and warm, but the structural coordinate of the remains would be absolutely bottom. But now I take a new sheet of paper and fold an airplane of it. My airplane is obviously more highly structured than my blank piece of paper. The question is now, of course, how do you evaluate the fact that it's been folded, and where do you place the structure in terms of a linear coordinate? Well, that was one of Heim's more difficult pieces of work, according to himself, to find a system in which you could evaluate all kinds of, well, that was a general system for evaluation, so to say, and which made a transition between quantifiable evaluations, like measurable entropy, and things you could no longer quantify, but only evaluate in terms of qualities, like things that have meaning, for example, the airplane, or later we're going to living structures even. This system he called centrometry. And this centrometry is the kind of scale we are applying to our dimension x5. I'm going to talk about this a lot in future videos. For now, I would just want to state there is a kind of scale. And what does distance mean on this scale? The concept of distance becomes the concept of similarity. Two structures which are similar, are close to each other. And two structures which are, well, virtually identical, they are at the same place, at the same coordinate, if you will. And two structures which have nothing to do, nothing in common, they are infinitely far apart. That's the kind of scale we need to imagine when dealing with coordinate x5. So now coming to dimension x6. If I fold my airplane in the process, I will have different intermediate states. And it is quite obvious that in the process of folding, there can only be a very specific order of these states. You already know that each of these states represents a certain structure, that means a certain coordinate on the axis x5. The axis x6 now, it orders these structures into a meaningful order, how they can be implemented in space-time. It's something trivial. You know very well that you cannot at first fold your wings and then take your sheet of paper and fold it in two. x6 is the order of evolution of my structures and my will to promote this evolution. The property of dimension x6 is also the reason why time does not run backwards. According to Einstein's equations, it could, but it doesn't. We don't observe it. And the reason is, that very property. The direction of evolution is determined, and it only goes from the piece of paper to the airplane, not vice versa. It only goes from the nut to the tree, not vice versa. And therefore, for the purpose of my videos, I'm calling the dimension x6 teleological. That means giving a goal and direction to evolution. The classical term that Heim used, aeon, he later himself found it's not very appropriate and suitable. So let's use teleological. And now coming to the more metaphysical meaning of the additional two dimensions. Everything we consider real, in terms of physical real, meaning things we can do physics with, that's located in 1 through 4. And now we have these two additional axes which are beyond space and time. They transcend space and time, and therefore Heim also called them the trans realm of the world. And there we can now locate and place things that have up to now been quite immaterial to us by classical physical thinking, like ideas, like our psyche, our mind, the concept of evolution. These things now, they become real in a physical sense, in a sense that is connected even to classical physical models. Being beyond space and time means they are nowhere to be found in the universe, they are everywhere behind the universe. And you can start to imagine where this will lead us. Our reality has suddenly become much, much richer. And as I said at the beginning, these additional dimensions are something that is quite in accordance with your everyday experience. Try to pay attention to things that where you can say one structure is more complex than another, or pay attention where structures are evolving, like plants growing, people changing their minds, etc. These dimensions have always been there, literally. You have only never had an idea of how to describe them. This was the first introduction into Burkhard Heim's six-dimensional world. If you enjoyed it, like the video, share the video, subscribe to my channel if you want to support my work, have a look on my site on Patreon. I will continue publishing Burkhard Heim videos in English nowadays, in six dimensions and in color.